Hey everybody, what's going on? It's Junior and Chill here, and today we're going to talk about how to set up your team, like who's your main damage dealer and like which ones to pick, because that's the main question I keep on getting like every single stream. People are like, who do I use for main DPS and blah 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 blah, and why would I do that? Alright, so I got a clip right here from the stream. Go ahead and watch it, hopefully it helps. Besides, I don't forget. But yeah, there's like a bunch of stuff I want to go over with like, because people keep asking like, oh, who do I use as my damage dealer, da 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 da. So, here's the thing. Maybe Barbara will just stop talking. I don't know. Maybe she will, maybe she won't. You know what I'm saying? But anyways, so with your DPS characters, right? You're going to have like, you have your teams. There's like two big pieces of advice I want to give everybody. One, I suggest for most content that you do, like the majority of content you do, you pick, you're going to have to pick like a character. You're like, hey, this is my main DPS. And then based off that character's like attribute, as in like Electro, you know, Pyro, whatever, right? You make a two set team. Like you want to have resonance. You want to have resonance, right? So you get like two Electros, two Fires, two Waters. You get the idea, right? And then usually, other than when you do Geo, you want to have an Anemo character in the mix, because Geo doesn't mix with Anemo, doesn't swirl, okay? But like everything else swirls, and swirl does like crazy damage, right? So there's that. Because the swirl reaction, like the Anemo damage from the thing that you do can crit, but the swirl, like the reaction itself cannot crit. So that's why. And there's only two things that can crit. It's electric and fucking Anemo, okay? There's only two things that crit as far as elemental stuff. So, yo, what's up? So anyways, so with that, like, keep that in mind. Like, so that's why Anemo is really strong. That's why a lot of people use electric, because Electro is like crits, right? So you can already do big ass damage and it can crit. It's like, wow, that's no brainer. So when you look at your characters, like I said, you look at what you're going to build to make a two set team. Like you're going to have two electrics, something that mixes really well with electric, like water, right? And then an Anemo user. You're gonna use two fire, an electric character, because you can do overload, which is really strong, and an Anemo character, right? You see what I'm saying? Like you have the synergy builds. That's kind of the thing. That's why Fischl's so good, because Fischl can be used in nearly every single comp really well. like Fischl is obviously really good for electric comp. She's obviously really good for fire comp. She's obviously really good for water comp, and also really good for like most other comps. Like she just works everywhere because she kind of fits that bill of as support DPS, not main DPS, but like support DPS and reaction DPS. So you're using her for her reactions to create bigger damage, right? So you take that electric character plus majority of other types will do crazy damage, right? You take those, put those together, and then you swirl it usually, right? And it works out really well. And she has like that bird she can put out for a long ass time. She can do her ulti to do the bird out again. So it's really, really good. So you want to like, you kind of want to build it that way. So that's kind of how you would set it up. Now there are times where you might build like some other weird shit, but that's like usually very few amount of times. And then also if you go on Abyss will have very special builds that will be, some of them will be more beneficial than other ones. But no, if you put a lot into it, like you really like, you invest into what kind of characters that you have in your artifacts and stuff like that, you can make the majority of characters work out. Did you guys know that you could use a character like Noelle as your main DPS? She's not the best main DPS choice, but you could actually use her as a main DPS. Like she actually slaps that hard. That she can actually be categorized as a main DPS character. So there is a lot of, like, I'm going to go through like a couple characters here. Like I have everybody except for three characters. I'm missing three motherfucking characters. Okay. And like when Klee comes out, I'll have that character, and I'm missing still three characters unless I get lucky and I get another one. Anyways. So with this, I'll show you a couple characters that are like the best characters that you use potentially for your main DPS. And then like, you can go off of there. Like this, be like, hey, I have this character. Cool. I'm use it. So one of the stronger ones right here, Razor. He's like an A tier, like main DPS. Like you could use him for your electric team. He's your main damage dealer. You have Diluc, fire characters. He's the main DPS. He's one of the strongest guys out there. Okay, super strong. You have Who else is main DPS? You can have Ningguang. Ningguang is not the strongest of characters because of, like, there's just some kind of, like, restriction right now. Not restriction, but, like, it's just some of the Geo characters currently are not super OP feeling. So, but, like, most mages are not that high rated as far as main DPS. They're usually reaction support and support DPS. So, but she can hit really hard. All these characters, I'm not going to tell you, like, whether or not you need constellations or not. I'm just going to go off of, like, because most likely, I'm just going to assume everybody has a no constellation character. That's all I'm going to go off. From there, everybody can change. So there's that. Bennett actually is a really strong DPS. At first, I was like, he didn't seem like, I thought he was a straight up support. And I kind of, like, more looked at him. Like, this guy is actually really damn strong. If you could build him as a very awesome support character, and, you know, doing damage buffing and freaking reactions and all that shit like that, that's why he's so good. But he also does damage. Like, he does a lot of damage. So you can actually use him as your main DPS. So if you're using a fire team, you can use him as your main DPS. Chengyang. For ice users, he is the strongest, just like raw strongest, for main DPS. So you can use Chengyang for your main DPS for ice teams. We also have Shengling. She is really strong. Her only thing that, like, I feel like is kind of hard with her, and it's not that hard. It's really not that hard, especially if you're already AR like 30 plus. Like, this part's not hard, but it's kind of hard to get her to have a high enough energy recharge to make her very strong, make her, like, really strong. Okay, that's the thing you have to do. So there's that. But she can be a really, really strong main DPS. Just throwing it out there for you guys. Main character can be a main DPS. It's just, like, that's probably, like, your last resort. If you don't got shit on your account, there you go. It's just weird too, because they're a Nemo at the moment. They're a Nemo and they're Geo. So, and those are not very strong main DPS classes, or, you know, like elements. Like, just, it's very hard to make a team with those and then have, like, oh, that's my main DPS. Like, you're going to do significantly less damage, like, over time kind of thing, right? So, there's that. Lisa, I don't even think she could be, like, if she is, she's, like, C tier, like, super low for, like, your main damage. So it's, like, not the greatest. She can't, you can make her work. You can make every character work. It's just, like, compared to other characters that exist that you can potentially get, she's not the best. That's all I'm saying. Like, I've mained DPS Lisa in one of my betas. It was, like, fucking just fine. It's just, I needed a lot of stats. And she just does damage. That's it. You know what I'm saying? Same thing with Amber. Same thing. Like, she doesn't have a very, like, awesome kit where, like, you could do so much crazy shit. It's just, like, very, like, straightforward. Like, I do this. I do damage. I do charge attack. Boom. I do charge attack. Boom. I do, here's Baron Bunny. I do charge attack. Boom. Oh, I have an ult. You know what I'm saying? So it's, like, not the strongest of main characters. She, same thing with her. Noelle is, like, not the, like, greatest. She can slap. Like, don't get me wrong. You can build her and she will one-shot people. But it's also very slow. It's not the best. There's, like, a lot of better characters to use as your main DPS if you're trying to be faster, especially for Abyss and any kind of, like, dungeons. That's why speed kind of does matter. So that's the thing. Kaya, very, very strong for reaction. He is, like, super awesome ice reaction character, by the way. Like, I shun this guy so much, but real talk, like, he's a really strong character. He's way better later game, right? But, like, later game, that's, like, one of those, I don't want to talk about constellations, but if you get him, he's one of those characters. If you get a lot of constellations on him and you get him, like, late game, he's, like, he slaps super hard. And a lot of characters are like that, though. I know, she is a pretty decent main DPS, but compared, the only problem is that she is compared with, like, Razor and Fischl, and those two would be way better main DPS than Baidu, like, period. Because her cooldowns and her damage is so, like, it's not in your face. Like, Razor, I can literally throw him into a fight and he will immediately do crazy damage off the second the fight starts. Like, he can just go in there's like, hey, one shot, boom, you know, and, like, he just is very, very effective at killing stuff. I know, not so much. Now she can be, she's a very good character. She does really good reactions. She's a very great reaction character. She's a great off DPS, like a support DPS, but she's, like, for main DPS, like, she's not the best. Like, if you want the best, go to Razor. That's it. Or Ka-Ching. Ka-Ching, I don't have her on this account, but Ka-Ching is literally god-tier electric DPS, by the way. So I forgot, I don't have her on this account, so I kind of spaced it. She is, like, thumb good. Jean is also really good Anemo user. Venti is better. And Sucrose is, like, either tied with Jean or maybe, like, slightly lower. Like, It's kind of weird. Simon, could you do thing? Thank you. Hi, Simon, also. Also, the other person I'm missing on this account is Chi-Chi. I've never had Chi-Chi. She would never, ever be your main DPS. Just being real. She'll never be your main DPS. Like, she does not hit that. She's really fun. It's cool that she does healing and does damage at the same time. She'll never be your main DPS. Like, she's just way too weak compared to the other ice units. Like, compared to Kaya and Chunyoung, she does not hit nearly as hard as they do. Right? So, there's that. Sucrose, definitely not a main DPS. She's purely like support, like reaction, like character. See, David, we just went over like how to say his name. Holy God, Sinkyu, right? Sinkyu. But like Sinkyu. Jesus Christ. Anyways, so her. He is like by himself. He's not that great. He's not that great. Just he's also one of those characters, like if you happen to get a bunch of constellations, but I want to go that route, but you get a lot of constellations, he gets really strong. But compared, like for currently for DPS characters, that's why I kind of skipped over like Mona real fast too. Like these characters, like Water doesn't have good main DPS at the moment. Maybe in the future we'll get some like really like baller freaking like worthwhile building a water team kind of characters. At the moment, not that great. You, like right now, you kind of like want to put like maybe one water character in here and there. You put like Mona, or you put like Barbara, or you put the Sinkyu. Like you can do a double thing, but at the moment, right now at 1.0, we don't have a great main water DPS where it's like, yeah, I'm gonna make a water team. You know what I'm saying? Like you just have like they're here. So that's it for all the characters. That's literally the whole cast. Right? Yeah, we went through the whole cast. For who's your main DPS, a lot of the characters can be used as support DPS. A lot of them can, but not all of them. But that's kind of like your idea. So like you kind of like look at what you have, right? Out of all the characters you have, look at like which like two person of the element team you can make and then go with that. That's my suggestion. So like, you know, also if you happen to get Klee, which she'll be coming out tomorrow, she is really like, she's almost as strong as the Luke, like level of like good for red teams, like for fire team. So like if you happen to get her, you're like, yeah, I want to run her like with Xiangling, fucking great. Or you have Bennett, you can run them together, they're gonna do crazy shit together, like it's gonna be awesome. So that really it's really, really up to you if you want to go that route. Her ulti is kind of like, her abilities are kind of weird because they're not like a lot of other things, right? Fun fact is if you have Jean, for example, you can like when Klee puts out her little mines, you can actually suck up all the mines with Jean and then shoot them out where you need it to be. Fun fact. So cool shit, like if you happen to have these like weird teams, you can create these synergies that don't normally exist. You can modify some characters to make them very strong. So that's the kind of cool thing about this game. You can go in there, you have these characters, and then you can take like some of their abilities and like you're like, hey, wait, I can mix this together. It's a game is a very about reactions, right? And then also her ult's kind of weird, but it's very much like, it's why you have to do auto attacks a lot, and you're just like, hey, it's a turret thing. It's kind of cool. You can do a lot of damage that way. So this is kind of like my quick-ish, like, who do you use your main DPS kind of guide, okay? So like gives the idea, it's a suggestion, it's up to you guys. But this is kind of like the, who are like the kind of the best characters, like some of the best characters, like I said before, Galook, Rick Razor's up there, Ka-Ching, who else is like, freaking Klee's gonna be really, really good. Those are probably the best main DPS characters right now in the game. And it is like, kind of behind. Xiangling can be up there. If you can build her correctly, she's up there with Razor. Like, she's really, really, really strong. And then everybody else is kind of like B-ish, C-ish tier. You know what I'm saying? Like, the main people is just, like, right now, is just the Luke, Klee, Razor, Xiangling, and Ka-Ching. That's like the strong. If you have them, those are the best main DPS characters. And there's, like, secondary DPS characters. Like, if you don't have those, the best ones for those would be, like, Venti, Fischl, Xiangling also technically, right? And then like that's it. Like everybody else is kind of like not as good as them. You could use them, but just not as good. Like these are, I'm telling you, like the best characters to use. Okay, so until that changes in the future, I'll let you guys know, but that's kind of what we have for right now. You know what I'm saying? So hopefully that helped you guys out. Hope you guys liked the video. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, and I'll be back again with another video for you guys a little bit later. Bye.